there, guys. SC Mothership checking in along with
SC Investor.
Going to be bringing you game number two of Reese versus Dongregu. We're playing here on Zelnaga Caverns. We got Reese spawning as the blue Zerg in the bottom left, and Dongregu spawning as the red Zerg at the top right. One of the most favored maps here of the original Blizzard ladder pool. And gonna be playing on here, although as time has shown, some certain races have better advantages on this, so turning out to not be one of the most balanced maps here, but still a really fun map.
You
don't have to worry about balance in a mirror matchup. If you're saying, oh, that guy plays there,
quite imbalanced. Quite literal mirror match, too. As we saw last game, they literally almost had the same exact timing for their first 3 or 4 minutes.
One really key thing, though, I think we're going to be seeing Dongregu go for a 10 pool. And then build 2 more drones, right when I say that. I saw he was...
and then build 2 more drones. He's like, oh, you think you can figure out what I'm doing, Mothership? I'm going to build 2 more drones.
He was, like, cutting there for a second. Like.
So I think we saw, actually, what was that, a 9 overlord from Dongregu? And look at the minerals. We're seeing they're actually quite constant. So I don't think there's actually that big of a difference if you're doing an 11 pool versus a 9.
Yeah, although I'm going for a 13 pool here.
I don't remember.
I knew something was off. Something was different. Like it wasn't mirror, and Dongregu was behind in drones. So I had to assume he was trying to. He's gonna be doing some sort of stealing timing.
Let's look at Reese while we're at it. Getting a 15 expand. Or maybe 16.
Oh, yeah, going for the hatchery first right there on the,
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think it'll be good if, Dongregu starts to pump out, like, 6 Zerglings as soon as it's done. I want to see. Let's click on this right now, actually. 20 seconds for one larva to begin. At this point, we're going to be seeing one larva come out, just as I said it. And I think he can only make around 4 Zerglings by the time the spawning pool is done.
I'm going to be able to build 2 here, but we'll see.
Four.
Yeah, right.
But
now we're seeing one pair of Zerglings come off and another pair right now.
Oh,
but
this
is what I was talking about. I wanted to say, Reese, this is really, really risky for him to be doing, especially
risky.
On this map.
No, I'm just kidding.
That was really punny of you.
You're funny. All right, let's go. let's go.
But yeah, it's really risky on Reese's part because this is close position. I mean, there's only one position where your opponent can spawn.
Yeah,
so doing a fast spawning pool, like, there's no trying to find out.
Was there a chance that Dongregu was actually, like, he knew that this was going to happen? Look, he's going for a roach warren, too. Actually, just normal timing.
But this, what having the second hatchery allows Reese to do is actually be able to produce more. He's going to have more larvae at his disposal, meaning that he has the opportunity to actually defend this more.
Oh, yeah, because he can't. Dongregu can't actually destroy this hatchery because Reese can produce the same amount, if not more, than Dongregu.
The two hatcheries, yeah.
And look at the overlord placement across the map too. It's gonna give him enough time to make a batch of Zerglings before non-metabolic boosted army reaches
what
the other side.
What was this queen doing out there? Did you see that? That queen was all
I guess he was... I don't know. I guess he was trying to attack an overlord.
She, good sir. Now we do see a lot more links, but Dongregu
does
have
speed. How do you know it's a she? It's like injecting sperm onto the hatchery, which is a female.
No, it's injecting eggs, and the hatchery is...
It's like releasing
fertilizing sperm. The eggs.
That's so weird, though.
Come on, Calvin.
I don't know. This is so weird.
Come on.
It's just weird. It's like spraying like green goop onto like I don't know.
But we do see Dongregu gonna be going for that that expansion here now.
Something for you guys to work on in the StarCraft wiki.
Queen
anatomy.
I'm pretty sure it's lit eggs though being spawned.
Queen anatomy. Roach is actually walking right past.
But look, more roaches for.
I know.
Already.
He's putting a lot of pressure on this base, but once that queen comes, the queen can help pick off the Zerglings, but it won't be able to do much against roaches. And especially considering the positioning, it's sitting in the front. Not too good. It's going down real fast. Zerglings, running the Zerglings into his base while he's pulling his army off, too. So his drones are actually going to stop mining for a couple of seconds.
Wow, this is actually paying off really
look at his minerals. I mean, he's been set back by quite a lot because all of his drones had to, defend. Look, He's got his roaches pulling him towards his own base. What can you do? Let's go back to his base and see if he's getting a static defense, because he is getting an expansion, but I don't know if he's going to be able to defend that if he's going to bring an army to his base.
Right, well, we are seeing quite a large army moving out here. Dummy is going to have to produce
more roaches. Yeah, more roaches.
I think he's going to have enough to defend it.
The more the merrier, man. More roaches. He's got to outnumber that at this point, because a queen really is equivalent to like half of a roach.
Yeah, we are seeing,
the queen's not going to be able to do much against that number of roaches.
Yeah, well, I mean, she can. She does not have enough. She does just now have enough energy to kind of actually almost going down.
Reese might actually. Yeah, Reese might actually destroy that.
Reese
getting.
Up on the ramp.
Surround. Oh.
Reese is piling in the units, trying to break.
Queen hasn't taken any damage yet, actually. The roaches are focusing on the other roaches.
Yeah, we did see one of those transfusions go down.
Queen dying. Slowly but surely gonna pick off.
I think Dongregu might be able to hold him. We're seeing a large mass of Zerglings.
Yeah, what's they're like the flip-flopping the flip-flopping whatever the other team was trying to do, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. Before Dongregu.
Now let's go to units lost. I mean, really, Reese had to pull off his drone, so I'd say they were quite even.
Well, if you look at the game right now, yeah, I was going to say, Dongregu does definitely not have enough to defend against all these units.
Yeah, because the larva counts
and this
low
is what
for
I was,
him.
Right, this is what I was talking about, where Reese got that hatchery up a lot faster, so even though he had less units, because he had more larvae, he was able to produce more at a time. So all he has to do is defend that first wave, and after that, Dongregu was behind
Let's
him definitely.
Flip the tables.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. It was like, that's what's one problem with ZBZ that a lot of people have, is that it's too...
It's larva based, really.
Well, yeah,
the more larvas you got, the more. And pulling out his queen there actually to defend and not injecting, I mean, that set a big toll on him, missing four larva.
Right, yeah, exactly.
He doesn't have a queen.
Yeah, so one thing I was going to say is, like, once you got that larva advantage and you have the economy advantage, Reese was up ahead
Dirty
for a little while.
Dirty secrets of Zerg economy.
But he basically, all he had to do was just build units and go keep drilling into his opponent, because there's no way his opponent's gonna be able to outproduce him at that point.
Yeah,
and it's a really good read there by Reese. I mean, you can't say much more about that, but this is one of the things I was talking about by this map being so it's because it's so small, because really, I mean, if you look at it, there's only one place your opponent can spawn. I mean, it's a relatively good travel distance, but as far as your naturals are really wide open, making
yeah.
it pretty vulnerable.
And
so.
Your third is especially, like, far.
Yeah, especially, yeah, really far from your natural. Anyways, really good game, game number two, tying it up 1-1. So we'll be going on to game number three. Hopefully, we'll see who takes the lead here.
Yeah.
Actually, wait, it just occurred to me. Reese won game one as well, didn't he? Not Dongregu.
No, Reese won. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So Reese is actually up ahead.
2-0.
Yep.
All right.
SC Militia
and SC Investor.
Check it out.